friends, welcome back to another Sunday Mass.
As we celebrate our nation's birthday tomorrow, let us be thankful for our home and nation as we pray.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving Father, we give you thanks as we celebrate our nation's 56th birthday tomorrow. We thank you for the safety of our home and country. Despite the COVID situation, we thank you for your mercy and grace through all our challenges. We pray that you will continue to bless us with good leaders and fill our homes and communities with your love, joy, and peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Last week, we learned that God loves us and is always with us. We can talk to Him any time of the day through prayer. But prayer is not just a one-sided conversation. God speaks to us too. Join us as we learn how to hear God and recognize Him in our lives.
Thank you for sharing your amazing artwork with us week after week on Little Faith Steps. The entries from our local and international friends are colorful and encouraging. We are always inspired by your sharing and beautiful artwork. Keep them coming.
Now let us sing this song to tell God how much we love Him as we know Him more and more.
You know, right? Last time you told me that I can ask God anything, at any time and anywhere, right?
Yeah.
Well, I tried it, and for a few days I kept God in my mind. And when I went about my day, I talked to Him, but He didn't talk back. But the other night, I woke up in the middle of the night, and it was super dark, and I was super scared. I closed my eyes so tight and prayed to God and asked Him to be with me. And guess what?
What happened?
When I opened my eyes, I saw the crystal crucifix that was on my bedside table. And it was like He was there, and I was not scared anymore. I didn't quite hear a voice or anything, but I think it was Him.
Yes, I'm sure it's Him.
Do you think that was God's answer to Joy's prayer? We cannot hear God's voice like we hear people's voices or the sounds around us. God speaks to us silently, and He speaks in a secret language, the language of the heart. We just need to tune our hearts to receive His messages just like how Joy did.
God can speak to us through different ways. He can use people and even things that happen around us to let us know that He hears our prayers and that He loves us. Sometimes, you can hear God's voice in you or through a word in the Bible. At times, He speaks through people like your friends or family or even through nature, like a flower or a rainbow or a beautiful sunset.
Yeah, that was probably Him.
I really think it was. Like, I felt so comforted, I felt so safe, and I really hope that I get to experience Him like this again.
You know, Joy, you will. You definitely will. God is always with you.
God speaks to us in small and quiet ways, but we need to quieten our hearts and be still so that we can hear Him.
When you read the Bible, be still and let the Word of God speak to your heart. You will then realize how His Word is always filled with the messages of love.
So remember to tune your hearts this week to receive God's messages of love. Let us sing this song and remember that our God of love is with us always, in every moment, in every move that we make, and in everything we experience.
Today we celebrate the feast day of St. Dominic. He is most known as the founder of the Dominican Order, also known as the Order of Preachers. St. Dominic also had a true love for prayer. In fact, Our Lady appeared to him with a beautiful wreath of roses and gave him the first rosary and taught him how to pray it. This is the same rosary we pray all over the world today. St. Dominic continued his ministry with his rosary in his hand, spreading the love of prayer and devotion to our Blessed Mother. Not only did he believe in prayer, but he said that we should never stop learning about God and His truth, so that people will learn to love Him more.
So this week, like St. Dominic, let us grow to love God by learning more about Him in the Bible and listening to Him through prayer.
For this week's activities, go to our Facebook page, Little Faith Steps. Like our page and share your works in the comments section with us. We can't wait to see them.
It is now time to set up your altar table and prepare for Holy Mass. Take a moment now to get these items and see you in a while.
Oh, don't forget to take a photo and post it on Facebook or Instagram with the hashtag CatholicMarsAtHome.
Let us now listen to what Auntie Estella has to share with us about something that we will see at Mass later.
At Mass, Father prays the words of Jesus over the bread and wine so that they become Jesus' body and blood. Have you ever noticed the special way Father gets the chalice ready? During the offertory, he pours wine into the chalice, and then he adds just a few drops of water. The wine, which is rich, sweet, and fragrant, represents the amazing power of Jesus' divine nature. The water, which has no color, smell, or taste, represents Jesus' human nature, which is so small and weak when compared with God. Once they are mixed, can the wine be separated from the water? No, they are together forever. In the same way, Jesus is both God and human forever. And because He took on our human nature, we are there in the chalice with Him. As Father prays, by the mystery of the water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled Himself to share in our humanity.
Thank you, Auntie Estella, for sharing with us about the water and wine. Let us now settle down, sit in front of your altar table, take a moment to be silent, and prepare for Holy Mass.
Welcome, my brothers and sisters in Christ, to the Holy Mass with children. Thank you for joining us to sing songs of praise and learning more about listening to God in prayer. There's nothing like giving God our hands and our voices to worship Him as our loving Father. Let us now worship the Lord together on the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time, 8 August 2021. We offer up this Mass for God's children everywhere, that we may recognize the bread of life that is offered to us. Join us in singing the processional hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Elijah went into the wilderness, a day's journey, and sitting under a fir bush, wished he were dead. "O Lord," he said, "I have had enough. Take my life. I am no better than my ancestors." Then he lay down and went to sleep. But an angel touched him and said, "Get up and eat." He looked round, and there, at his head, was a scone baked on hot stones and a jar of water. He ate and drank and then lay down again. But the angel of the Lord came back a second time touched him and said, "Get up and eat, or the journey will be too long for you." So he got up and ate and drank, and strengthened by that food, he walked for 40 days and 40 nights until he reached Horeb, the mountain of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise always on my lips. In the Lord my soul shall
comes. Never have grudges against others, or lose your temper, or raise your voice to anybody, or call each other names, or allow any sort of spitefulness. Be friends to one another and kind, forgiving each other as freely as God forgave you in Christ. Try then to imitate God as children of His, that He loves and follow, Christ loving as He loved you, giving Himself up in our place as a fragrant offering and a sacrifice to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Jews were complaining to each other about Jesus, because he had said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." "Surely, this is Jesus, son of Joseph," they said. "We know his father and mother. How can he now say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus said in reply, "Stop complaining to each other. No one can come to me unless he is drawn by the Father who sent me, and I will raise him up at the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'They will all be taught by God.' And to hear the teaching of the Father and learn from it is to come to me. Not that anybody has seen the Father except the one who comes from God. He has seen the Father. I tell you most solemnly, everybody who believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the desert, and they are dead. But this is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that a man may eat it and not die. I am the living bread which has come down from heaven. Anyone who eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I shall give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So, greetings, brothers and sisters, boys and girls, and hope you are all keeping safe and well. Today's reading touches on something very important. Try to guess what it may be. I'll give you just some clues. First, perhaps it's something we do every day because we need it to live. And second, it is something that some of us may enjoy doing a lot. Can you guess what today's reading is about? What's the reading touching on? If you have guessed, it is about food and about eating. We see this through Elijah in our first reading and in Jesus in today's Gospel. We see that like everything else in life, such as our family, such as studies, such as work, where they are meant to teach, to remind and point us to God, so too is food and eating. They are not just to nourish our bodies, to fill our stomachs, or to satisfy our cravings. They are also meant to nourish our spiritual life. They are meant to nourish us that we may build relationships and to serve one another. And we see this example of how food can nourish our spiritual life in this prophet Elijah in our first reading. Why Elijah was sounded so tired in the first reading was because before this reading, under God's command and with God's help, Elijah defeated or he won this battle against Queen Jezebel's false prophets. And so obviously that made the queen very angry, and so she wanted to kill him. And so that is why Elijah had to run for his life. This made him not only physically tired, but also emotionally. We hear how sad he sounded, didn't he, in the first reading? Perhaps also disappointed, maybe, because even though he did God's work, he found himself in even more trouble and even more persecution. Like Elijah, some of us, maybe your mom, your dad, or even yourself, may have felt this before, or maybe even feeling this today. We try to do what is right, but we get rejected. We try to speak for the truth, we try to speak the truth, only to be laughed at sometimes. We try to love, we try to forgive, only sometimes to be taken advantage of. How then, as we, as Christians, continue to do God's will, even in such persecutions, even in such outcomes? We look at what the angel said to Elijah. And that is two things, to get up and to eat. To get up from our sadness, to get up from our disappointments, recognizing that yes, our outcome didn't go as planned or hoped for. Because think again, what did Jesus say in the Gospel before? He said, "If the world rejects me, it will also reject you." But the good news, sisters and brothers, is that he also said that he will never leave us. But first, to recognize and to remember this, we must first get up. Get up so that, like Elijah, who got up and then he could see the food right before him, when we get up, we are able to see the blessings right in front of us, even in our sadness, even in our disappointments. Blessings such as at home, in the form of our parents, in the form of our brothers and sisters, in school, in the form of our teachers, our friends, and in the world, in the form of creation. But where do you think we can find that greatest blessing, the greatest presence of God Himself? The clue and the answer can be found in our Gospel, and that is in the Eucharist, because that is Jesus Himself, who today says He is the bread of life. Once we have get up, then the next thing to do, as the angels say, is to eat. But what does this mean for us today? How do we eat Jesus, so to say? How do we eat this bread of life? Especially now with COVID, we are unable to receive it regularly. Or some of us have not yet reached the age of First Holy Communion. How do we eat the Lord Jesus so that He may nourish our spiritual life? It is to invite the Lord Jesus to come into our hearts and into our life, so that when we invite Him, we invite Him to walk with us, both in the good as well as in the not so good moments of our life. For example, if we have someone whom we find it difficult to forgive, we invite the Lord Jesus. We invite Jesus to come into that relationship, that He may give us the strength and the humility to forgive. If you are feeling afraid, perhaps to invite Jesus into that moment, into that fear, that He may give us that courage to walk through the fear, reminding us that God is greater than our fear. In this way, just as food nourishes and strengthens our physical body, eating the Lord, eating this bread of life, while inviting Him into our lives, strengthens faith and relationships. And in this doing this, it is what makes it possible that St. Paul asks us to do in the second reading. And that is not to have grudges, not to lose temper, not to raise our voices, not to call people names. It's difficult on our own. And that is why we need to invite the Lord Jesus constantly, daily, into these moments, so that bit by bit, we can become more and more like the Lord Jesus. And so, sisters and brothers, boys and girls, as we celebrate this Eucharist today, let us get up. Get up that we may see the many blessings of God and eat Him by constantly inviting the Lord into our hearts and into our life. So that as we do so, as we are nourished and strengthened by the Lord who is the bread of life to walk through our difficulties with us, we may help others in return. Just as how God nourished Elijah in our first reading to give him that strength to make that journey to Mount Horeb. And so, in response to God's word, let us together renew and profess our faith in this God who loves us.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the Scriptures, He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified,
who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As a community of believers seeking to grow deeper in our faith, we bring our prayers and needs before our God.
We pray to the Lord. Our response is, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Archbishop William Goh, all priests and clergy, that they be blessed with strong health of body, mind and spirit. We pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all whose ministry has become tired and weary, that in Jesus, the living bread that comes down from heaven, they may be inspired anew and refreshed for service. We pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the church, our faith communities and families, that we bear with one another charitably, in patience and gentleness, and with mutual forgiveness in these pressing times. We pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For healing and recovery from COVID-19, that vaccines, oxygen tanks, medical supplies, and care reach those most in need. We pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For Mother Earth, our common home, that the spirit of creation stirs within us a greater love for the world placed in our care. We pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For vocations to the priesthood and the religious life, that there be sufficient priests and religions to serve all our parishes and communities. We pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the silence of our hearts, we pray for our personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Loving God, your Son, Jesus Christ, is the bread of life. Accept our petitions today as we come to you in confidence and love. We make our prayers in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him, you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in His fullness. For though He was in the form of God, He emptied Himself, and by the blood of His cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore, He has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey Him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
So at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
And so, sisters and brothers, as we now enter into the rite of communion, in your homes you'll be praying the spiritual communion. As we, particularly today, especially since Jesus says in today's gospel, he is the bread of life, invite you to use this time to invite the Lord in your own way, in your own words, to invite the Lord into our hearts, into our life, into our families, into our fears perhaps, into relationships we are struggling, and invite the Lord there to continue to walk with us through these moments. And know, as the Lord says, whoever believes in him will have eternal life. May we continue to hold on to that promise, believing that God is present in our relationships, in our lives, in our situations, and until we get able to receive the Lord physically again in the Mass.
We invite all those watching to make an act of spiritual communion with a spirit of gratefulness, thanking God for his infinite love and sacrifice. With humble and contrite hearts, let us express our desire to invite Jesus into our souls. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
I receive the living God, and I hope.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.